this isn't as sexy as a hot new iPhone app or something like that. But if you work inside a company, you probably have to build different kinds of applications that show databases and do stuff for the business. And you can't afford to go and hire some smart kid all the time. Sometimes you have to do it yourself. So what do you do it with? Well, we're going to see a new kind of tool called RapidBiz right now. Who are you?
I'm Terry Bird. I'm the president and one of the founders of VACAVA, and we're the makers of RapidBiz. And probably one of the most important things about me is I'm not a programmer, but I've always wanted to be able to program the ideas and the processes that we've had, but I've always had to either get a programmer, hire a programmer, and explain to them what I want. And you know, sometimes you get what you thought you were asking for, and many times you don't. Yeah. Well, RapidBiz is what we think is the first product that actually allows me to fulfill that dream that I've had.
Yeah. And we can tell you're not a programmer because you have a tie on.
That's because I'm an old IBMer too.
Oh man. Well, it takes us back, back when IBM actually had a dress code.
That's true. I don't anymore.
No. I've been covering this industry for a long time, and I've seen this kind of programming being done inside companies for a long time. I got my start at Visual Basic Programmers Journal, mm-hmm. where a lot of people were building these kinds of apps for a work group or a, you know, even a company-wide thing, but it was something that they wanted to build right. to have a look into a database or show, you know, show some business process or even build a screen for somebody entering data, but do it fast without having to go through the IT department and wait, you know, 6 months for them to get around to it and, you know, budget it and all that fun stuff.
Sure.
And that's what this is aimed at, isn't it?
Well, that's exactly what this is aimed at. This is aimed at when people want to have something done right now, they have a tool set that allows them to do it, and better yet, it deploys it immediately to the web.
Yeah.
So if you want to get that information out to your customers, your suppliers, your team, you can do that literally in a matter of minutes or hours today with RapidBiz.
Yeah, and so it's not a programming language. It's an IDE, basically. It's not even an IDE. It's a development environment for right. building websites that let you build corporate infrastructure, right?
Well, exactly. I mean, we probably don't use it to build websites so much. We build it applications. I mean, we've built applications where people send us spreadsheets and say, we want an application out of this, and we want some workflow and all those other things. I mean, those normally are hour, 2 hour, 10 hour types of jobs that we do for those folks. But we have other people that also want to build ERP applications and modules that connect to existing ERP solutions, because I think we all understand that ERP, you know, it's great, and it provides a wealth of features and functions around the process, but it can't do everything for everybody every time.
Yeah.
Well, that's where RapidBiz really shines, is if you need to extend an existing solution, whether it's ERP, financial, or anything, then RapidBiz can probably do that very easily.
So we have some assumptions here, right? One, you're using a web browser. Two, you have probably a database of some kind, either SQL Server or MySQL, right?
We actually use DB2.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you force that, or can you hook up to existing database systems that are being used inside
companies? The foundation for RapidBiz is DB2. Yeah. However, you can literally hook up to any database you can establish a connection to.
Okay.
We also provide a web service so that you can literally go in, define your web service, define the fields that you want to pass, define whether you want to be a one-way or a two-way web service, and then give it to somebody so that they can consume that in their application.
Yep, and then it's a visual designer, which is really nice. If you need a name control and you want to have somebody enter in names to a database or display names. You can lay that out, right? And then you can put an address field and a,
What you see is what you get.
I mean, but it's drag and drop.
It's drag and drop. You drag and drop. You size the fields to the size you want them. You hook them to the database field or column that you want it hooked to. Drag a save button on the screen. Boom, you got an application.
It's that easy.
It's that easy.
Cool. And how much does this cost?
Well, we deliver it in the cloud, and our cloud that we use is Rackspace.
No, thank you.
Yeah. And it's $100 for the development and deployment environment where you can deploy 5 applications. It is $50 if you just want to buy an app and then run it. So what some people do is they take the $100 offer, they develop the application, then they shut that one down and turn on the $50 offer, which is the runtime environment where they can run the application.
And is that per year or is that one time?
That's per month.
Per month.
Per month. Okay. Per month. So if you're done at the end of a month, shut it off and you don't pay any more than your $50.
Now on my computer, is there a runtime? Do I have to load up Visual Basic or .NET or
100% web delivered on standard IE and Firefox browsers. Yeah. Those are the two we support all the way up to IE9 and Firefox 4 something. So it's just standard browsers.
And I bet it would work on Google Chrome and Safari, right?
It actually does.
Yeah.
They're not tested and approved browsers, but it does. There could be some weird things that take place, you know, in terms of how something might look, but fundamentally they work.
Okay. And so we build this app and it's pretty easy and I have a variety of fields, right? What kind of fields can I lay out?
Any kind.
So give me a sample of when I'm laying out my forms.
You can lay out your forms. You can drag standard just text fields on.
Okay.
You can drag numerics on, decimal, integers. You can drag drop down boxes on, define the contents of the drop down box. Radio buttons, check boxes. You can even bring on things like other iframes. So you can literally render another application right inside a current application.
Ooh, that's interesting.
Yeah. So when you're doing things like maybe you want to, in the application, be able to reference the FedEx shipping information, boom, the application, it's right there.
Can the application talk to other web services through REST APIs?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Git and Post normally is the ones we support.
Got it. Very cool.
Yeah.
And so we have our forms laid out. Can I do any computation on those forms? Can I say add up these 5 numbers? Can I do any programming? Real programming?
I mean, there's several ways to do programming.
Yeah.
First of all, if you're a programmer, you can do a lot more than I can do. Because
right.
You can use JavaScript and you can do all sorts of neat things at a screen level. But even I, as a non-programmer, can come in and I can use the tools we have in kind of a calculator type of a form that really goes in and says, well, I'd like this field, which is my first amount, and I want to add that to my second amount and put it in this column.
Got it.
And it's very easily done.
So it has a rudimentary kind of programming model. It's not a programming language. You have to use JavaScript if you're going to get really crazy, but it does have some rudimentary ways to do event-based
kind of
display.
As a matter of fact, I mean, we almost went overboard in some places to try and remove some of the programmer language. Yeah. And what you'll see in some of our help techs and our guided learning capability is we do a lot of explanation that's non-programmer-ish, or explaining it in a way where a non-programmer could understand it to hopefully better understand how they could use the function.
Do you have a search field so I could type Procter & Gamble and have their record come up, for instance?
It's really even easier than that.
Okay.
I mean, you have the ability to, you can drag the fields on that you want to search. Say you had a database that had all your customers in it.
Yeah.
So you can literally drag those fields onto the screen, drag a view onto the screen, say that's going to be a search view, and then drag a search button on and designate it as a search button, and boom, it now, those fields act as search fields. So when you put in Procter & Gamble, it searches the database and retrieves Procter & Gamble into that view.
Or whatever company name you have.
Or whatever you want to put in there.
Very cool.
Whoever's in there.
very cool, easy to do.
Yeah.
So now we have our app built, and it looks good. Everybody's happy with it. How do I deploy this thing, and where does it stay? You know,
because when we developed it, we knew that you couldn't just do it so I could develop it, and then I got to hand it off to a programmer, and then the programmer has to deploy it. We didn't want that. Literally, all you got to do is change a radio button from in development to deployed or active, and it is now available on the web. And it's available to whoever you give the URL to, and of course, who's authorized to actually go after the application.
And there's probably a place to see the URL for the shipped app?
We provide both a URL link as well as an iframe link. So if you want to paste those into other applications or websites, you can do that.
I can take some of those iframes and put them into a meta app that's like a dashboard of the business?
Absolutely.
Oh, that's cool.
Can.
Wow.
See, we charge based on applications. So our fees are very small, so we charge based on the app. And so like the $100 deal, you get 5 apps.
Yeah.
Well, if you want to go add another app or another 5 apps or whatever, there's a charge on a per app basis. The beauty of it is, though, we don't restrict how big you make the apps.
Yeah.
You can take one app, put your own menu screen on it, and have a whole bunch of application components underneath it that you use that screen as the menu to go around.
Very cool. Give me a sense of the range of kinds of apps that people
We've got a customer today that uses our applications, and what they are is they are a bag distributor. And these are all the way from those very big, large industrial bags that they hold feed and those types of things in. What they use our application for is managing all of their purchase orders and all of their artwork that goes with those bags. Mm-hmm. And they have suppliers in China, Vietnam, and India, I believe. And so the application sets on their servers in this particular case, and it is used by all of the other sublocations to fill in the information relative to what the schedule is, when something ships, when it gets on a container, what the size of the container is, all of the things that, you know, would be in an ERP application most generally. Yeah. And what we do is we supplement their current ERP application because it doesn't have those capabilities. So we actually trade information back and forth in that.
Very cool. When you deploy one of these apps, where is it deployed to? Is it on the Rackspace cloud, or is it running on a server inside your infrastructure? What?
If you want to run it in the cloud, run it in the cloud, and it'll be in the Rackspace cloud. You can also put it on your premise if you like. So you can download the code, run it in on your premise. A lot of the customers that we're seeing, they kind of like this idea of what we're delivering, and they kind of want to try it. And so a good place to try it is in the cloud.
Yeah.
The beauty of what we provide also is the capability to very easily export that app along with its data, taken down to your own server, import it in, and boom, you're ready to go.
Yeah, this is why Rackspace invested so much in OpenStack, the open source cloud infrastructure, because a lot of companies are going to run that in their own data centers, have their own private clouds, basically. And I bet you can deploy right to that private cloud because that's the same code as is running on Rackspace cloud.
Yeah. We tried to do more than just deliver a tool set. We're delivering an entire environment. Because if a developer is developing something in RapidBiz, they have the ability to put it in our Ready Apps catalog where they can now sell it. So a customer comes on, finds the app that they want to purchase, boom, it goes into the cloud, they use it, and we pay them the monthly fee that they set on theirs. We take no commission on it whatsoever. We're so confident that you can build applications with this quickly. We're going to have an application invitational. What the RAP invitational is all about is you come in, you build an application, it's going to be judged with everybody else. We're providing a $2,000 prize for the best programmer developed app, $2,000 for the best non-programmer application, and then there's a couple second prizes, iPads for the runners up.
Very cool. Where do I learn more about the contest?
www.rapidbiz.com.
So it'll be on the homepage.
That's where you
learn more about RapidBiz as well.
For sure.
Are you guys on Twitter or Facebook as well?
We are indeed.
So twitter.com/RapidBiz?
You know, I don't know.
Okay, we'll look that up.
We'll have to get that looked up. But we got it.
Very cool. Well, thanks for coming out and showing me this enterprise tool.
It's not every day. I appreciate the opportunity to be able to tell you about it.
Yep. And thanks for being on the Rackspace Cloud, too.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.